Acoustic guitar pickups. Which one is the best? Which one will work for you? Do you even need a pickup? Look no further than today's show because I'm going to answer all of those questions plus dispel the biggest myth there is about acoustic guitar pickups. Hey TAC family and welcome to episode number 167 of the Acoustic Tuesday show. This show is designed to bring fun, focus, and progress to your guitar journey through my weekly Guitar Geek lists, plus meeting your fellow TAC members. This week you're going to be meeting Guy H., who went from music listener and appreciator to guitar player only after becoming an empty nester. You're going to learn about Guy's story here in a bit, plus I'll be reporting on some headlines from around the acoustic guitar industry, including a new album from my favorite singer-songwriter, one of my favorite singer-songwriters, two guitars that are totally mind-blowing and have immediately entered my wish list, and lastly, an acoustic guitar cover of a disco tune that you won't even believe. In fact, you have to see it and hear it to believe it. But first, let's go ahead and dig into acoustic guitar pickups. Before I teach you the five different types of acoustic guitar pickups and which are my favorites in each category, I want to dispel the biggest myth that surrounds acoustic guitar pickups, and that is this. You have to be a certain level of guitar player to have a pickup. You have to be worthy to have a pickup on your guitar, and that couldn't be any further from the truth. Acoustic guitar pickups can benefit any type of guitar player, whether you've just started and you play in your room alone, just by yourself, or you jam with others and have been playing for a while. Every single guitar player can benefit from having a pickup on their acoustic guitar. In fact, it opens up a whole world of opportunities for you, three of which are as follows. Number one, it allows you to plug into an amp, which is awesome because you get a little bit of a different perspective on your playing. Plus, it opens up the option to experiment with effects, which is truly creative and extremely fun. The second opportunity that it opens up for you is that it allows you to very easily participate in an open mic or some sort of public setting where amplification is required. Now, this might not be in your future, but it is an opportunity that becomes available to you and becomes much easier when you do have a pickup on your guitar. And the final opportunity that pickups create for you is it makes recording a breeze. No muss, no fuss, plug in your guitar and get your ideas down right away. Now, I'm not talking like big studio recording here. I'm talking simply creating. If you have a cool idea and you want to record it quickly and of decent quality, it's nice to be able to plug in your guitar. So now that we've dispelled the biggest myth and proven that, you know what, regardless of what type of guitar player you are, regardless of your experience, having a pickup can benefit you in a huge way. In fact, it can even supercharge your guitar journey. Let's go ahead and dig into the five different types of acoustic guitar pickups and my favorite in each category. So let's start with the most common, and that is the undersaddle pickup. The undersaddle pickup lives under the saddle of your acoustic guitar. It's a thin strip of piezo crystal material that acts as a conductor that takes string vibration and basically turns it into electricity. What are the pros of this pickup? Number one, you get a clear articulate signal. Number two, a lot of times these pickups are active, meaning they're battery powered, so you get a stronger signal plus access to volume and tone controls if the pickup you choose comes with them. And then the third pro of this particular pickup is that aesthetically, it doesn't even look like there's a pickup on your guitar. Now let's go on to the cons, the negatives of this pickup. Number one, there's some slight modifications that need to be done to your guitar. The biggest one being a small hole drilled through the soundboard of your guitar. It's in the saddle slot underneath the saddle, so you won't see it, but you should know that it needs to happen for this type of pickup. The second con of this particular pickup is that it has a tendency to sound a little bit unnatural and quacky, meaning it can sound kind of clicky and you kind of miss the attack of the string. Like you don't hear the pick noise, so it can sound a little bit weird. And then lastly, there's some setup modifications that need to be done to account for the height of the undersaddle pickup. Since we're adding something underneath the saddle of your guitar needs to be shaved down just a little bit to accommodate for that extra height. That all being said, my favorite pickup, my favorite undersaddle pickup is the Fishman Matrix VT. A phenomenal pickup, easy to use, and really truly a dependable, kind of roadworthy pickup. All that being said, let's go ahead and hear an undersaddle pickup in action. The second type of pickup you'll encounter is the bridge plate transducer. These pickups generally have 2 to 4 elements that sit on the inside of your guitar on the bridge plate and pick up vibrations from there. In my opinion, these particular pickups come with a whole boatload of positives. The first one is aesthetically, you can't tell there's a pickup installed unless you look at the end pin jack. The second positive is the tone that you get. These pickups sound awesome, they sound natural, and really are kind of effortless to use. And the last positive is that generally these pickups are passive, meaning there's no batteries involved, so you don't have to worry about switching out a battery. But these pickups aren't all good news. They do come with a few negatives. The first of which is that these pickups are prone to feedback. Because the actual contacts are on the soundboard of your guitar, that kind of ups the frequency of feedback in terms of how often it occurs, not the actual frequency of feedback. The second negative of this type of pickup is that adhesives are used to keep the contacts on your bridge plate, and most often it's super glue. And this won't harm your guitar in any way, shape, or form. It won't hurt the resale value, but it's something you should certainly know about these pickups before getting them installed. Now, that all being said, this type of pickup is indeed one of my favorites, and my favorite in this category is the K&K Pure Mini. So let's go ahead and hear a bridge plate transducer pickup in action. The next type of pickup that we'll dig into is the magnetic sound hole pickup, and the name pretty much suggests everything here. It sits in the sound hole of your guitar and uses magnets to pick up the string vibration. In fact, 6 individual pole pieces pick up each string, so think electric guitar pickup but voiced for the acoustic guitar. This pickup is good at a lot. In fact, the first thing that it's really good at is resisting feedback, so if you're playing at louder volumes, this is definitely a pickup to consider. Also, if you like to experiment with effects, magnetic sound hole pickups pair with effects extremely well. You get great results. And lastly, magnetic sound hole pickups are very easy to use. A lot of them can be permanently installed. In fact, all of them can be permanently installed, but there's also a temporary installation option, meaning you can just pop it in and out of your guitar as you see fit. But this pickup isn't all roses and candy and other flowery things. This pickup does have a few negatives. Number one is that it doesn't sound all that natural. Because of where it actually picks up the string vibration, it sounds, well, actually a little bit more like an electric guitar than an acoustic guitar. Not totally, but, you know, it edges towards electric land. Electric Ladyland, Jimi Hendrix reference. Anyways, we're talking about acoustic guitar here. The second negative about this particular pickup is that aesthetically, you can see it. That's not a deal breaker for most, but it's something I should mention. And then lastly, I want to mention that if you use the temporary installation option, a lot of times that can leave cords hanging out of the front of your guitar. If you happen to step on one of those cords, you can cause damage to not only the pickup, but the soundboard of your guitar. I don't want to see that happen, but I do want you to be aware of it in case that's the route you go. That all being said, I do think that magnetic sound hole pickups have plenty of benefits, and I wanted to mention my favorite to you. In fact, I was going to pick a 3-way tie for this particular category, but well, I'll share with you the 3 that I like, and then I'll give you the winner. The 3 that I like are the DiMarzio Black Angel, the Sunrise pickup, and the Fishman Black Stack. But when taking into account price and performance, I go with the Fishman Black Stack. So, well, let's go ahead and dig into a magnetic sound hole pickup and hear what it sounds like. The next pickup we'll look at is an internal microphone pickup, which is literally a microphone mounted inside of your guitar. This pickup has a ton of benefits, and the front runner is if you're a percussive guitar player, meaning you hit the body of your guitar and you want those noises amplified, this pickup will do that for certain. The next benefit is its natural acoustic tone. Since it is a microphone, it's hearing exactly what your guitar produces, which is pretty darn nice, again, if you're kind of a tone tweaker like me and like most guitar geeks. And then lastly, this type of pickup can be combined with other systems to fill it out. Meaning if you have an undersaddle pickup and you like the clarity, but you want a more natural sound, add a microphone pickup. If you like the benefits of a magnetic sound hole pickup, but you want a more natural acoustic sound, go ahead and add an internal mic. This type of pickup does indeed have its negatives as well, and I think the biggest is feedback. Since it's a microphone, it has a tendency to be a lot more prone to feedback. Also, I will say that placing an internal microphone can be difficult at times. You gotta get the sweet spot for it to sound really good. And then last, its negative is that it picks up body noises. So if you're not a percussive guitar player and you don't want any extra noise, don't get an internal microphone pickup because it pretty much picks up everything. Now I want to share with you my favorite pickup in this category, and it actually is a dead even tie. I have two favorite pickups and I can't pick which one's the best because they both work kind of subtly differently. My first favorite internal microphone pickup is the Envitone Model Duo, and this particular pickup works best, I think, when combined with other systems. And then the last internal microphone, or I should say the other internal microphone pickup that I really love, is the LR Bags Lyric pickup. This pickup functions phenomenally by itself, and all that being said, let's go ahead and listen to both right now. Final type of pickup that we're going to look at today is a mounted external microphone. I'm not talking about any old microphone you put in front of your guitar, although there are a lot of great ones out there. I'm talking about a microphone that's actually mounted to your instrument. Now, I've experienced these before in studio, and they come with quite a few benefits. The first is tone. You get truly natural acoustic tone because it is a microphone listening to your guitar from the listener's perspective. The second thing that I think these mounted external microphones are good for is that they're not permanent, meaning if you have multiple guitars, you can take this microphone and mount it to any of those instruments. So one external microphone for a myriad of instruments. These do have some downfalls though, and I will say that feedback is a major issue if you use these live. Also, aesthetically, they look kind of goofy. It's like your guitar has an antenna. I will also say this. Visually, these can kind of get in the way because the microphone is right up on the guitar. So if you're looking down towards the 12th fret, 14th fret, you might kind of get distracted because the microphone is there. All that being said, there is a stellar mounted external microphone that I think every guitarist should try, and that is the DPA 4099. This is it's a truly incredible microphone, and one that I've had great experiences with, both live and in studio, and I have to say, the tone that you can get out of this microphone is mind-blowing. Let's go ahead and have a listen to it. Here's a quick recap of the pickups that we discussed. The undersaddle pickup, the bridge plate transducer, the magnetic sound hole pickup, the internal microphone, and the mounted external microphone. Now that you know a little bit more about pickups, let me know which one you favor in the comments below. And if you truly have a favorite pickup, make sure to let me know the brand and which type it is, again, in the comments below. Now I want to introduce you to a fellow guitar geek who went from music listener and appreciator to full-on guitar player only after becoming an empty nester in the short span of 2 years. This is TAC family member Guy H. Guy H just celebrated his second TAC-iversary, and in that short span of time, Guy dove into a solid guitar routine, bettered his skills, and attended the Acoustic Life Festival in 2018. Not only did he attend, he also performed at the open mic and had a blast meeting his guitar geek friends. Here's Guy H's story. Before I joined Tony's Acoustic Challenge, I could only play open chords and simple songs if I had the chords and words in front of me. I had no idea why chords went together or even what the fret markers were for. But here's a little more backstory. So, I bought a guitar when I was 19. Loved Dylan, Young, the outlaw country sounds. I never learned to play it, but I always kept it around. I guess getting rid of it meant abandoning the dream of one day being able to play. Fast forward 35 years or so, kids have moved out and started careers, and we moved to a cool little mountain town where they have an open mic each month. All kinds of folks, newbies and pros, play and all are welcome. This is cool. After seeing a group called Steel Wound do this song, I walked out determined to finally learn to play. I've been at it since then. Discovering and joining TAC allowed me to step up to another level. I was so encouraged and inspired by my fellow TAC members and so many others. I spent lots of time, like many others, in YouTube land, but TAC provides a foundation and just an immersion into acoustic guitar that is truly unique. Here are three things I can do now that I couldn't do before Tony's Acoustic Challenge. 1. Play a song by ear based on chord / scale knowledge. 2. Play some fingerstyle tunes. And 3. Play with others and know what I should be doing. It would be amazing if this time next year I can play good breaks and solos and songs and fills between chords, play the James Taylor song Carolina in My Mind, and play a couple of songs by my TAC friend Daniel M. I want to thank Guy so much for sharing his story, and I had the chance to meet Guy at the Acoustic Life Festival, and it was so cool because it was actually the day after the festival. I had seen him play an open mic. I believe his wife sang with him as well, if I'm not mistaken. I could be mixing up people, but this seems a little too memorable to forget. I believe his wife sang with him at open mic. And the following day, I actually went out to breakfast, and there was Guy and his wife. And Guy tapped me on the shoulder and he said, I just want you to know how awesome this was. And it's so cool to see that. It's so cool to hear that. But more importantly, it's so cool to continue to see Guy progress, continue to see him posting videos, playing, and just having a blast with guitar. So thank you so much, Guy, for sharing your story. And thanks for being just an awesome, well, model guitar geek. Cheers to you and your guitar journey. Speaking of Guitar Geek family, let's go ahead and dig into some guitar snolls from our very own Acoustic Tuesday viewers. I've got two of them for you today. One comes from Nevada, one comes from California. Let's go ahead and start in Nevada. This is Mike Augie Augenstein from Reno, Nevada, and here's what's in his guitar snoll. He's got a gold tone Paul Beard square neck, an Emerald X10 with MIDI output, a 1971 Martin D28 that he bought used in 1972, a Randy Allen Jumbo C, a Takamine GJ72 12-string, and an Ovation T1778 Elite with orange flame. Next, let's meet Kay Reynolds from Santa Clarita, California, and here's what's in his guitar arsenal. He's got a Martin D28 and a Gibson Hummingbird in his hands. To his right is a baby Martin that he bought his son for his 6th Christmas. Next, we have a PRS Alex Lifeson acoustic, a Gibson J45 Sunburst, on the couch over his left shoulder, a 2002 Gibson Les Paul Standard in Burgundy, a Gibson Les Paul ES Memphis Alex Lifeson, number 38 of 200 in white. Front and center is a 1978 Gibson Birdland Burst, a Geddy Lee Jazz Bass, and he says, yes, I love Rush, rip Neil Peart. A 1964 white Telecaster, a Seafoam Fender Jazzmaster, an EVH Wolfgang Gold, a Fender Strat in Burst, and he says, great show, Tony. I have learned so much from you. Thank you and go Kings. I guess I can get on board with that knowing you're a hockey fan, but I have been watching some old hockey highlights, and I just came across the playoff series when the Kings ousted the Hawks out of the playoffs.
Williams moves it into the corner. Reddy lost his stick. Puck comes out to Martinez. Martinez with a shot. It's in! The Kings are headed to the Stanley Cup Final. The shot by Martinez deflected it.
Ouch. That hurt a little bit. But knowing you're a hockey fan, it's okay. I'll let it pass. If you want to be like these fine guitar geeks and submit your guitar arsenal picture, please do so. It takes 3 simple steps. Number 1, go to acoustictuesday.store and pick out your favorite guitar arsenal shirt. Get it shipped directly to your door. The second step is to put that guitar arsenal shirt on and take a picture amongst all of your guitars. And then finally, please submit it at acousticlife.tv. There's a submit link in the top menu. Click on it and you can upload your picture, and then your guitar arsenal will be featured on a future Acoustic Tuesday show. Before I let you go for the day, I want to share with you some bits of acoustic guitar industry news, and the first bit comes from Jeffrey Foucault. If that name is not familiar to you, it absolutely should be, because he's one of the best singer-songwriters out there today. In my opinion, he's one of my favorites. He just released a brand new album entitled Deadstock, Uncollected Recordings 2005 to 2020. This sees some reworked old songs from him, but also some new releases as well. This is an album you can stream right right now, and of course, you can purchase physical copies, which I strongly recommend that you do so. If you need a little sonic snack right now, here's a tune off the album entitled There's a Destruction on This Land.
In the judgment every day, there's a destruction on this land. Can't you see? Now you see how God is riding.
Your next piece of acoustic guitar news comes from the folks at Mule Resophonic Guitars. One of their original team members had a bit of misfortune, and they used the power and healing of music to help them along. You're gonna look at some pictures, and I have to tell you, there's some grisly pictures here. But the story is pretty amazing, and it goes to show how much guitar can truly mean and how much it can bring community together. Here's what's left of Dustin's Mule. Dustin and his wife lost their house in the wildfires in California. Dustin is an OG Mule team member. I think he got his first in 2014 and was the first guitar we shipped to a deployed member of the military, if I remember correctly. I was hoping we were able to incorporate some of the original guitar in the new one, but it wasn't possible. We talk often about this method of buying and making instruments for individuals as a mechanism for connection and community. The guys and I were upset hearing about Dustin's home, but were also excited to be a small part of Dustin and his wife's life moving forward. Incredible work by Matt and his team at Mule. And if you want to help, if you want to contribute, please check out Mule's Facebook page as there's some details on how you can help out Dustin and his family moving forward. Your next piece of news comes from the folks at Heartbreaker Guitars. Usually I wait for their Heartbreaker of the Month. However, I was on their website doing some digital shopping. You know, no big deal. It's what happens late at night sometimes. And I found two absolutely mind-blowing guitars that you need to know about. Whether you're in the market for these guitars or not, it doesn't matter. You need to see these. They're absolutely gorgeous. The first one comes from Santa Cruz Guitar Company. It's an OM that features bullseye spruce. This spruce top is so insanely figured, it literally looks like there's a bullseye around the sound hole. The back and sides of this guitar are East Indian rosewood, and the top has this beautiful torch inlay, if I'm remembering correctly. A stunning torch with the Santa Cruz Guitar Company logo incorporated in it. Stunning, stunning, stunning. I know, I've said it a lot, and I'm gonna say it again, because the other guitar comes from the folks at Bourgeois. It is a large sound hole OM with the most jaw-dropping set of Zerikote back and sides I have ever seen. These guitars are incredible. Like I said, whether you're in the market or not, you simply need to know about them. The next news nugget that I have for you comes from the folks at Didario. Their playback string recycling program in the year 2020 was responsible for recycling 6 million sets of strings. Holy smokes, that's a lot of strings. Congratulations. Their goal for 2021 is 8 million sets of strings. Now, I've been a bad guitar geek and I haven't been recycling my strings. However, that's going to change this year because I want to help them achieve that goal. So if you want to learn more about Didario's string recycling program, please visit didario.com/playback/recycle. The final piece of acoustic guitar news that I have for you today is an insane cover of a disco tune on the acoustic guitar. It comes from Luca Stricagnoli, and he's playing the Bee Gees tune, Stayin' Alive. Check this out, you won't believe it. When I first saw that, my jaw was literally on the floor. Number one, the performance is mind-blowing. Number two, he had to conceptualize that entire arrangement. Truly, truly stunning. Let's go ahead and take a sneak peek and see what's gonna happen on next year's Acoustic Tuesday show. Yes, next year. It'll be a new year, and next week on the Acoustic Tuesday show, I'll be chatting about the pitfalls of guitar-centered New Year's resolutions and what you can do to avoid them to make 2021 your best year of guitar yet. Yes, that's all happening next week on the Acoustic Tuesday show. Remember, you can catch Acoustic Tuesday every single Tuesday at 10 a.m. here on YouTube. Thank you so much for joining me today. Thank you for being a guitar geek. And remember, your guitar progress, however you define it, is only as good as your guitar routine. So invest time in developing a solid guitar routine and have fun every day you play. Thanks again for joining me today, and I'll see you next week on the Acoustic Tuesday show. Cheers, and Guitar Geeks Unite.